In this section, we're going to start thinking about doing validation around a database. I want to first kick off this section by explaining two possible scenarios to you around our products table right here. So remember, our products table has an ID, name, department, price, and weight. I want you to imagine for a second that maybe our company has some administration user. So this is some user who is in charge of adding new products to the products table that we're trying to sell. Let's say that this admin user is using some web interface to add a new product. So maybe they type into some form inside their browser that they want to create a new product with these attributes right here. Presumably, we would then take that little form submission, send it off to some web server, and then it would be up to the web server to create a new row inside that products table somehow. Everything there sounds totally reasonable. There's just one issue. I want you to take a look at this product that we're trying to create very closely. Notice that the product has a price of negative 35. In addition, it also doesn't have any weight assigned to it as well. So if we try to enter in a price to a products table of negative 35, that's almost implying that we're going to pay anyone who purchases this product. That is definitely bad. We don't want to pay people who's purchasing our stuff. We want them to pay us money. So it's very clear that we'd probably need to implement some kind of validation at some level here. A very common solution for this would be to implement some validation at the web server level. So our web server, which might be written with JavaScript or Python, who knows what, might use some validation, make sure that this product that's coming in has a name, department, a price that is a number and positive, and a weight as well. And then if it fails any of those checks, we might send some back or some kind of error back to whoever is making the request and say, sorry, but this must have a positive price and a department. And so we've captured this entire validation step at the web server and immediately sent a response back to this admin user. Now this entire scenario right here, totally realistic. It could totally happen. As a matter of fact, it happens every day. Anytime you use any web application and you submit any information, there's probably some validation going on inside there to make sure that the info that you're trying to save is of some valid format. But I want you now to think about some alternative scenario. So here's scenario number two. Let's imagine now that at our company, we don't have the resources to put together some kind of web interface to add products just yet. Maybe we are an early stage startup and we just don't have any web developers who can sit down and build a website where some admin user can enter in some product information. So what would we do in that scenario? Well, our admin user might instead connect directly to the database using something like pgadmin. They might connect directly to the database and try to manually add information in. So what would happen now if a user tried to submit or add some kind of invalid product to the products table? Well, in this case, right now, we don't really have any validation anywhere. Not only, well, in our database, haven't even really created one with our local Postgres installation yet, but even as we've been talking about our products table throughout the course, there was no validation inside there whatsoever. All we said was, hey, as long as you're submitting some values that kind of conform with these different types, everything is good to go, and we'll take any product you want to add. So in this scenario, a administration user who's connecting directly to the database could very easily add in some invalid information. And that would result in us having a product with possibly a negative price. And there's nothing in here right now to catch that kind of mistake. So in this section, we're going to take a look at how we can add in some levels of validation to our database or specifically to individual tables. We're also going to have eventually discussion around where we might want to add validation at the database level versus sticking with validation at a web server level. So that's the theme of this section. That's what we're going to be going over. So quick pause right here and let's get to it.